Just another grey, wet English afternoon, but not just another racing car going through the motions of pre-season testing. The car, a brand new Formula One product of Ireland. Its creator, an ex-banker, driver, entrepreneur, Eddie Jordan. The team's number one driver, the much-travelled Italian Andrea De Cesaris, with 161 starts to his credit without a single Grand Prix victory. Together, this unlikely duo have formed the base of a fabulous first-up season in the big time. One of the great thrills for any motor racing buff is to take a walk down pit lane, look up above the garages at the famous names, names like Lotus, Brabham, Tyrrell. All those established teams are now struggling in this championship. Not struggling, the newest team on pit lane, the Jordan team.
Obviously, there are names that you've just mentioned, teams that I've held in great standing for years and years and years, and of course at this moment in time we're ahead of them in the championship, and obviously it gives me a great sense of thrill. We have a very young bunch of totally dedicated and motivated people, so that obviously has something to do with it. I think we have been in racing for 20, 21 years, so obviously a lot of the experience that you pick up in the junior ranks, really all we've done is to progress that into a Formula One situation, and at this moment it seems to have worked.
Few new machines have worked their way along pit lane as quickly as this car and team. It's been the talk of the Grand Prix circus from the very first session the car's wheels was turned in anger.
The car gives confidence, I think. Or this is the feedback we're getting on the technical information from the drivers, that the car is quite stable in the corners, turns in quite well, puts the power down, and it actually applies it. I'd say that the V8 engine probably helps that situation. It's less complicated, it's small, it's light, it's tidy, it's aerodynamically very quick, and I think, as I was saying, the growth of the confidence within a driver, within three or four laps he's still going quicker and quicker, and he feels he's nowhere near his limit.
Confidence runs through this team. Each man, no matter the position held within the team, is willing to do the job of two.
I'm actually the team manager, and also I engineer one of the cars.
I mean, we number in the whole team from top to bottom, 43 people.
Amazing, isn't it, with the success you've had?
Yes, that's right, that's great, yeah. It's the whole thing, really, is the teamwork. The whole package is good.
The Jordan driver lineup has changed a number of times through the year for a number of quite bizarre reasons. First, Bertram Gasho was jailed for assaulting a taxi driver. New boy, Michael Schumacher, was snatched by the Benetton team in one of the sport's most public brawls. Eddie Jordan still winces when asked about the incident.
Were you cheated with him, you think, Schumacher?
Honestly, without question, yes, but then life isn't always fair, and maybe if it hardens us up in certain areas for the future, the last thing I want is sympathy. Absolutely. We can't survive on sympathy. We want to get in there amongst the big boys, and if there's some punches being thrown, we're going to be the people who throw them just as quickly. And I think that's the attitude. We're not going to be rolled over, but we want to do it in a professional and a sporting fashion. No problem.
Schumacher's replacement, another new face, Alessandro Zanardi, who has already been touted by many as a coming star.
I'm happy for that because now I have very good chance. I think I'm very, very lucky man, and I like to use my chance on the best way, you know.
The young Italian almost blew his chance during the first practice session. It's incidents like this that keep Zanardi on that learning curve.
Because one time you are here, one time you are here, and then another time you crash on the floor, so you don't know, never.
After a day being swept along to the tune of the big V8s, 10s and 12s, Eddie Jordan's big escape is through a tune of a different drum when he joins the Pit Stop Boogie Boys.
I mean, this is a very long, hard gruel, isn't it? It's 9-10 months. I think you have to do other things. If you were to say devoted to motor racing all the time, you become A, very boring, and B, very insular. And I think there are other things in life. I went to see AC/DC last night, a bit noisy for me, but I like a bit of headbanging now and again. There is another side to me. I like music. I played in a band about 20, 25 years ago. And backing people such like Van Morrison, who's still going strong. And I like music. It's probably my best source. If I wasn't in motor racing, I'd like to be a producer.
Head is yours.